Yeah, Diego. And I'm thinking maybe I should make a small piece of the vlog in Afrikaans. So ek gaan nou 'n bietjie Afrikaans praat. Ek hoop julle kan dit verstaan. Ek dink daar's baie mense in Nederland wat dit sal verstaan. Maar hier in Suid-Afrika kan heel wat mense Afrikaans praat. Dit is ons eerste taal, alhoewel ons baie Engels praat in Suid-Afrika. As jy in Suid-Afrika wil bly, dan sal dit beter wees om Engels aan te leer. I just said, if you want to live in South Africa, it will be better to learn some English. Of course, you're going to use it. Diego is daar op die jungle gym. Nee, dis Enzo daai. En hy gaap al skoon van die honger. Maar hulle gaan binnenkort eet. Hier kom Diego aangestap saam met Spider Cat. En hulle weet dat die kos nou naby is. Ek is maar versigtig met die kleintjies hier naby, want hulle sal agterkom dat hulle nie met Diego moet Peter deur die draad nie. Alhoewel ons hoop dat hulle daai les maklik leer en nie op die harde manier nie. Daar sê Diego stap gou 'n bietjie daar om by die swembad en hy is maar 'n bietjie verveeld. Hy het nie veel om te doen vandag nie. Enzo is heel gretig om af te kom. Kom ons kyk hoe klim hy af. Let's see how he comes down. And now a jump. Nou gaan hy spring. En landing. Hy is altyd so vriendelik. Hè, pa se seena. Ooh, dis pa se seun hier jong. That means this is dad's boy. Absolutely amazing. Hulle is absolute pragtige tiere. Daar's iets omtrent 'n tier wat jy nie kan vergelyk met enigiets anderster nie. Hulle is groot, sterk en baie mooi. Mooi is the word that we use for pretty in Afrikaans. So if something is mooi, it means that it is very good looking. En Diego is toch so gaaf. En kyk uit vir hy stert, want waar hy mik, tref hy gewoonlik. Maar as jy vinnig genoeg is, dan kan jy uit die pad uitkom. So, dit is hoe dit klink as ek Afrikaans praat. En ek dink dit klink heel anders as enige ander taal in die wêreld. So, dit is waar die verskriklike aksent vandaan kom. En enige Afrikaner wat nou hierdie luister wat ek sê, gaan weet van ons aksent. As ons by mekaar kom, dan maak ons eintlik grappies oor ons aksent. En ons dryf hom eintlik nog dieper in as ons die Engels praat. En dit klink gewoonlik baie snaaks. En maar ek moet sê, ek geniet die Afrikaans. Dit is my baie lekker taal. Ek geniet om Afrikaans te praat. I was just saying that I really enjoyed speaking Afrikaans. And if a couple of us comes together and we start talking Afrikaans or English with that Afrikaans accent, we can have a good laugh about it. Because that accent is even funny to ourselves. Now I can push the accent a little bit, because there's certain words that you have to really push a bit more when you want to speak English and your Afrikaans. I can try and do it. It's actually, that's what we're doing if we want to have a real good laugh. But words like the becomes the. So it just sounds so funny. It just greet Diego back there. Like I'd say, this tiger is really big. That would be pushing it so far. And this tiger is even bigger. We don't really speak like that. But that is, I think if you want to learn a South African accent, you're going to have to practice speaking like that. And then tone it down a little bit. But believe me, if we speak to each other with that Afrikaans accent, we really laugh like you won't believe. Dit is een van die grappigste goed wat ek in my lewe nog gehoor het. En baie van my vriende doen dit. That's one of the funniest things I've ever heard in my life. And many of my friends do it. He is just watching the guy who is installing the cabling on top to get the DSTV back on. And it will be on in a few minutes. But these tigers are really like God tigers. They watch everything. Diego doesn't really pay attention to much, but Enzo is very much a keeper. He is one of those, now if I say keep, I don't mean one that you call, what that you keep, one that he protects the area, and he's got the instinct for it still running in his brain. When he hears something funny, he will go and hide away first and come and sort it out later. He's not taking any chances. He's one of those real intelligent type of tigers. Where if I look at Diego, he's also intelligent, but he's so laid back and relaxed. But I think they make the perfect combination. Die perfekte kombinasie van twee tiere. En ek dink nie dit kon 'n beter kombinasie gewees het nie. Wel mense, dit was lekker om vir julle hierdie storieetjie te vertel in Afrikaans. Ek hoop dat julle 'n bietjie kon verstaan het. That is so close, but yet she is doing it right. They are something amazing, but I want to keep them as safe as possible. And it's difficult to think that you can be at your safest next to a tiger cage. Because I remember having that problem with you don't feel safe. And since I've had my tigers, I have really felt safe. It's just a different kind of threat that is out there. And I think the tigers just knows how to cancel the other threats, because they can eat those threats, and that is something to always keep in mind. But yeah, they are just paying attention there now. Look at them. Always funny to see how they make those calculations and how they get to a conclusion, because now they are analyzing and they want to try and figure out what is going on. His eyes are up, down, and look at them communicating with one another. Now that's something that I once said the word that, and that is going to give a lot away about tigers. They're the military version of the big cats, and I'll explain that sometime. But I know that in a few of these videos I have been talking a little bit too much, saying a couple of things that can scratch someone a little bit, and but yeah, I'm slowly gonna take it, bring some of the stuff I know out, and believe me, it's going to be interesting. I'm sure you're going to find it real interesting. So hang in there and listen to some of my stories. I've got a few stories still to tell, and then the next one that I'm working on now is about my date of birth. I was born in 1974, 11th of September. And that is a very difficult date to use as your birthday. And it wasn't like that always. But then I want to tell you guys how those numbers have been following me throughout my life. And they always pop up. But that will be a story for another vlog. I'm getting it together to show you just how the numbers can come up in your life. and it's actually very funny, and it's not coincidence whatsoever. But thanks for watching, and hope you enjoy that. Have a good day.